Alan Stratton from Meswood Turns. In the last video, I described my phobia about wooden balls, and I turned a couple just to get over it. But part of that process was to have a system to turn the balls. And I chose one that was not expensive, did not require an expensive commercial jig. So I've made some faceplates to fit my lathe. One for the headstock, one for the tailstock, although they're mostly interchangeable, and two sets, one for larger balls, one for slightly smaller balls. So let's get into this video and show how I made these faceplates.
I'm starting with a piece of poplar about 3 inches in diameter and 2 inches thick. I've closed down the jaws on the squirrel chuck. The wood is held between the surface of the closed jaws and the tailstock. This enables me to tool the full edge of the plank with a gouge. Then I'll turn a dovetail tenon. This will enable me to mount the blank in the squirrel chuck. For this faceplate, this tenon will be cut away later. Now I've flipped the wood around and mounted it in the chuck jaws. I like to thread my faceplates, even for use on the tailstock live center. If you don't have threads on your tailstock, such as if you have this live center, you would probably want to drill a hole sized so that the wood fits snugly over the live center. If it's a little loose, a couple of wraps of masking tape could snug it right up. That said, I prefer to thread the faceplate. Back to my faceplate. My live center is a 3/4 inch diameter and 10 threads per inch. I need to drill a 5/8 inch hole for the tap. I'll drill at very low speed with a Forstner bit. There's no sense in burning my bit with a higher speed. I'll lubricate the hole with a little beeswax and mineral oil mix. I'll mount the tap with its edge just inside the hole. The other end is supported by a small recess in the end of the tap that goes over the point of the live center. With more practice since my faceplate video, I've gotten faster even at real-time speed. I'll use a pair of vice grips to rotate the tap. As I turn the tap, I'm tightening the tailstock to keep pace. I'm using the tool rest to hold the spindle lock in place. Now, before you all tell me about the hinge to hold the spindle lock, my lathe is a Powermatic 3520A. That hinge would interfere with access to the on-off switch. That's important. Besides, the spindle lock is located closer to the spindle, easily accessible with even the short tool rest. When backing out the tap, the chuck came loose from the spindle. I used the hex wrench against the tool rest to stop its rotation. I'll drill out a bit more with a 1 1/2 inch Forstner bit. This enables the faceplate to seat on the flat behind the threaded portion. This cannot be too deep for my lathe or it will rub on the tailstock. I'm using a skew to scrape a short chamfer where the threads begin. This helps the threads easily engage when mounting it to the tailstock. I'm also cleaning up the face of the faceplate. This is not necessary, but makes it look fresh and new. I'll trim a little more to make sure the faceplate is still round. I'm making these faceplates interchangeable between the headstock and the tailstock. The threads enable the tailstock mount. Now I need a dovetail tenon on this side of the faceplate. This tenon will mount to my squirrel chuck, so each faceplate is then bilingual. Now I'll flip it over to finish shaping the faceplate. On this one, I'll leave the thread hole to become the recess that holds the ball. On the other set, I glued on another layer of poplar to cover the threaded hole to make a smaller cup for smaller balls. Finally, test the new faceplate on the tailstock live center. It works. The final touch is to mark the jaw marks on the tenon and number them so that I can always remount it in the same position when used on the headstock spindle. The other faceplate is nearly identical for either the headstock or tailstock. The second faceplate set for smaller balls has an additional layer of poplar glued onto its face. Then I was able to turn the cup for a ball smaller than the 3/4 inch threaded cup. Part of conquering my ball turning phobia is to have the right process. This process includes simple faceplates that cost much less than a dedicated single purpose jig. Come back for the next video as I go to an extreme to wipe out the phobia forever. So be sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel so we can keep you updated. Have fun and be safe, and always wear a full face shield. This is Alan Stratton from as wood turns, and we'll see you on the next video.